Big news coming out of California, out of Washington on multiple stories today. President Trump says he'll send the military to secure the border with Mexico. Also, the special counsel reportedly tells Trump's legal team that the president is not a criminal target in the Russia probe. Could this whole sordid mess finally be winding down? Plus, Trump accuses Amazon.com of unfairly driving retail stores out of business. And we'll talk to a reporter who's blowing the whistle on a brand new national security scandal for Democrats. You don't want to miss this story. But we begin with a number of important new developments on illegal immigration, beginning with that possible deployment of troops on the border. Fox News chief national correspondent Ed Henry brings us up to speed with the latest from the White House. Ed.
Jason, great to see you tonight. The president had already been ramping up the rhetoric on illegal immigration the last couple of days as that caravan makes its way through Central America, through Mexico, towards the U.S. border. But tonight, he's trying to back it up with actually dramatic action, declaring he wants to send the U.S. military to secure the southern border until that wall is built. The president today convening a meeting here at the White House with the defense secretary, other top cabinet military officials, to say that in the absence of action by Congress, he wants executive action to crack down on illegal immigration, drugs, violent gangs coming from Mexico and elsewhere. Tonight, White House officials are making clear the president is talking about mobilizing the National Guard to secure the southern border because active duty military is prohibited by law from getting involved in domestic law enforcement. Yet that distinction seemed to be lost on a lot of Democrats and a lot of people in the media today. Watch.
It is a dangerous thing to do, to put U.S. military forces on the border with an ally like that.
This is not a country where U.S. military force is used on the streets of this country.
I would rather have the dealings with immigration be handled in a civil context and not a military one.
Not mentioned is that then President Barack Obama did something similar in 2010 as George W. Bush did in 2006. 2010, the Obama administration sent about 1,200 National Guard troops to the southern border. They mostly focused on dealing with intelligence, surveillance, reconnaissance, not direct interdiction. The Bush administration, something similar, basically sent about 6,000 members of the National Guard. They were focused on road and fence building, transportation, surveillance, logistics. Again, not direct interdiction. So what the president seem to be saying today is he may be looking at a more aggressive approach where the National Guard perhaps takes on a more direct law enforcement role. Plus, a senior official is telling us tonight the number of National Guard troops will be quote unquote substantial, suggesting a larger number than ever before. Watch.
I told Mexico, and I respect what they did, I said, look, your laws are very powerful. Your laws are very strong. We have very bad laws for our border. And we are going to be doing some things. I've been speaking with General Mattis. We're going to be doing things militarily. Until we can have a wall and proper security, we're going to be guarding our border with the military. That's a big step. We really haven't done that before, or certainly not very much before.
Former Mexican President Vicente Fox firing back on Twitter, quote, real Donald Trump, to militarize the southern border is to provoke more hate, distance even further between our nations. Somebody has to talk some sense into him. He's elevating his hate towards Mexico, causing a greater conflict. As for the current Mexican administration, they had their ambassador specifically ask the White House officially today for clarification on the president's remarks. We're told by White House officials the president's Homeland Security Secretary is in contact with the Mexican government to lay it all out, Jason.
Oh, thanks, Ed. Joining us to discuss all these developments are Monica Crowley of the London Center for Policy Research and Enrique Morones, founder of Border Angels, an advocacy group for illegal immigrants. Thank you both for joining us tonight. Enrique, I want to start with you. You hate that this president wants to secure the border, put up a wall, lock it down. That's not something you want to see, is it?
Well, first of all, I don't represent illegal anybody. These are human beings, and I, like most of the people in the country, do not support Trump's agenda of hate. The border is already militarized. There's already a wall that covers a third of the border. It's led to 11,000 deaths. And Donald Trump is a person totally out of touch with reality. I really support, and I was really encouraged today when I heard Stormy talking about the fact that he does have little hands. I don't know where she was going with that, but one thing I do know is he's a very dangerous man. He's incompetent, and the whole world is saying, what happened to the United States?
Enrique, let's go back to your first point here.
Sure.
People that cross the border illegally are here illegally, correct?
Yeah, but they're not illegal immigrants. There's no such thing as an illegal human being.
What, just like people were called wetbacks and three-fifths. If they're here illegally, I mean, enshrined in the law, it says they're an illegal alien. So,
yeah, but also it said three-fifths of a human being or wetbacks, and those terms were eliminated later because they were very racist.
No, the law doesn't say that.
No, but
I didn't use that derogatory term.
You didn't,
Jason. If they come here illegally, they're here illegally. They're illegal.
No, they're not illegal human beings. They've committed an illegal act.
So they're here illegal. Oh my goodness, Monica.
Yeah, yes. Yeah. Well,
Monica, is the president yes. doing the right thing here, locking down the border, getting rid of the rewards and incentives, and making sure that people don't flow here illegally?
Of course he's doing the right thing, and this is one of the primary reasons why Donald Trump is currently the president of the United States. How
Very
refreshing! No,
what?
No, he's not, actually.
Hugely unpopular. And, the most unpopular president.
Okay, he was more popular than Hillary Clinton. He was more popular than the 18 other Republicans.
Do
you believe, wait, Enrique, do you believe he's the president of the United States?
Donald Trump is a person that was not elected by the majority. He is incompetent.
Get a grip on reality. Is Donald Trump the president of the United States? Duly elected.
He does not have a grip. No. He's not the duly elected president of the United States. There was a lot of
corruption. No wonder you think it's okay to come across the border illegally.
I don't think that.
You don't think he's the legally okay, Monica?
No. I don't encourage people crossing. There's been a 40% drop in undocumented immigration in the last 5 years.
Enrique, let's go to some rational thought here.
Okay,
go ahead, Monica. Go ahead.
Okay, Jason, how refreshing to have an American commander-in-chief who means what he says what he means, and is willing to enforce America's immigration laws and enforce the border. This is one of the big reasons why he is president. We have had presidents on both sides of the aisle who have refused over many decades to do that. We either are a nation built on the rule of law and are interested in protecting our own sovereignty, or we're not. Donald Trump stood up and said, America's borders are worth enforcing. The American people, the American taxpayer, the American worker are worth defending. And I, in fact, am going to do it. This man has now issued two warnings. He issued the warning on the caravan to say, unless Mexico stops, I may, in fact, revoke NAFTA. And I'm going to take other action. I'm going to put the U.S. military in the form of the National Guard
on
the border.
There's one other subject I want to get to. And one of the things I'm concerned about is since 2016, more than 100,000 minors have crossed that border illegally, and then they've been released and given out, literally given over to criminal gangs and who knows who else out there. Does that bother you, Enrique, that we're taking minors and putting them into the custody of somebody we have never vetted?
So you're saying they're putting these minors in the hands of criminal gangs. Who are those criminal gangs?
MS-13 specifically.
Most of the people that applied for asylum and that showed up at the U.S. border did not get it. And those that did get it were turned over to family relatives, not MS-13.
Wait a second.
So, Jason,
Enrique,
it's important that you get your facts correct.
I mean, I am 100% correct. The number is 107,000 people since 2016.
There's Fox, and then there's facts. So are you going to talk about facts, or are you going to talk about Fox?
No, don't. Enrique, you are so off base here.
Get it out there. You can do a lot better than that. I know you're just filling in.
I gave you specific facts.
Okay, give them to me.
I did. 107,000 people have been turned over as minors, and we don't know who these people are.
You said the criminal gangs.
That is one of the groups. There is
no. They were turned over to family members.
It's called asylum. Enrique,
you're
living on a different planet here. Hold on.
There's 250 million undocumented people in the world. U.S. only has 11 million.
Enrique,
most don't come here or want to come here.
Well, that's why we're going to lock down the border.
Monica,
shed some light to people on why 100,000 kids are given into the arms of who knows who.
Well, that's right. And it's not just the children, although the children are a useful tool for those who want to continue to see illegal immigration go forward, because it's an emotional play, right? It's an emotional draw on the hearts of very generous Americans. That they try to shade this in shades of gray when actually it's shades of black and white. This country is very generous. We want people to come here, but we want them to do it the right way, whether they're children or whether they're adults. There is a legal process process in place for a country built on the rule of law.
And, every country in the world is a country of rule of law.
Abuse,
name
the
one
abuse,
that isn't.
The abuse
Nazi
of our
Germany
system.
Nazi Germany was a country of rule of law.
Excuse me, Enrique.
North Korea, those are countries of rule of laws.
So now you're equating the United States with North Korea?
I'm talking about facts.
Try to get in or out of North Korea.
Oh, you mean Trump's buddy? They're going to have a meeting? Trump's buddy?
Here's an important point, Enrique. In the years 2015 and 2016, Mexico actually deported roughly twice the number of Central Americans out of the country than the United States did. Yeah. So Mexico is very interested in enforcing their borders and enforcing their rule of law and protecting their people.
Name a country that's not.
The United States for a long time actually wasn't, because the Republicans wanted cheap labor and the Democrats wanted votes ultimately.
Once again,
Now finally, we have an American president who's interested in protecting
Donald
our sovereignty and the rule of law.
He's being ridiculed all over the world.
No.
He's a very dangerous man. That's why he's so unpopular.
Enrique, you've had more than your opportunity to say what you wanted to say, but I got to tell you, the United States is the greatest country. Listen, Enrique, the United States of America is the greatest country on the face of the planet. They're not trying to break out of the United States and get into Mexico or somebody else. That is not happening. We have to leave it there.
Right now.
Thank you both for being here tonight.